Good afternoon and welcome, friends. It is the Subway AUS Men's Soccer Championship here from BMO Field. The Acadia Axemen taking on the Cape Breton Capers. I'm Mike Specht along with Dom Blakely. And Dom, we've got a great afternoon of soccer here.
You know, it's going to be great the way the tournament has already wrapped up. It has been rolling along. Great competition. Players are pushing hard. Nice today. No wind, no rain. Just let the players do what they've been doing on the field.
And looking at these top-seeded Acadia Axemen, what are you expecting from them in this game?
You know, Acadia's been playing a little bit more defensive as they've been going along here in the tournament. They've got to be able to hold the fort against a really high-flying Cape Breton speed. So I think you're going to see a little bit more of the same, holding back, trying to take advantage of their opportunities, slow play, play it out of the back, and work it forward.
And conversely, the Capers, how do you think they'll take on these Axemen?
Well, you know what? What we saw them do in overtime the other day, unbelievable. They showed their speed. They showed their capability with the ball. They also showed that they can actually shut it down, too. At the end, last 5 minutes, they were under a lot of pressure, and they can hold it from the back as well. But I expect to see high speed, pushing to the ball, and getting the wings involved really early on.
Thank you so much, Dom. And now we're going to send you to the third member of our team, Roger Surrett.
Just looking at these two teams going through their semifinals, a 1-0 win for Acadia, 2-1 in overtime for Cape Breton on Friday. Both these teams will be ready for today, even though both teams are going into the Nationals. They certainly want to go in through the front door. And if you look at the game within the game, you got to look at center back Andrew Snyder, who's the reigning MVP here in the AUS against Corey Bent. The striker who got both goals in the semifinals. That's going to be certainly the matchup to watch over the course of the 90 minutes. And also Nigel Goodwin, the keeper for Acadia, very strong in net, very athletic, and dive from left to right and make those key saves. We're going to take a short break. First half action coming up here at the Subway AUS Men's Soccer Championships. It is the Acadia Axemen against the Cape Breton Capers.
It's AUS football season, and Bellaline 5TV1 has you covered. Strong rivalries run deep as the X-Men, the Mounties, the X-Men, and the Huskies battle it out all season long. And with 5TV1, you won't miss a game. For hard-hitting, adrenaline-pumping AUS football, there's only one. Bellaline 5TV1, live on Channel 1 at 4:01. Football so intense, you won't know what hit you. Watch AUS football presented by Subway, the official fuel of Atlantic University Sport.
Welcome back, friends. We are just moments away from the opening kick here at the Subway AUS Men's Soccer Championship. Mike Specht alongside Dom Blakely. And Dom, we're almost ready to go here. How are you feeling?
You know, I'm really excited about this game. The tournament's been fantastic to date. Just watching the way that they're playing. We've had a bunch of weather that's been affecting the rate of play, hammering the ball up into the air, being knocked around. No wind today. Lots of rain, ball skipping all over the place. It's dry today. It is cool, but you know what? I think we're just going to be able to see the guys play.
And looking at the lineup here for the top-seeded Acadia Axemen, in goal, Nigel Goodwin, Matthew Berrigan, Andrew Snyder, Zachary Visser, Sean Langell, Corey Cadeau, Cooper Coates, Travis Fenning, Tyler Connolly, Michael Wilkinson, as well as Ryan Paris on the back end there. And for the number two-seeded Cape Breton University Capers, in goal, Jamie Wilson, then followed by Daniel Pritchard, Robson Doolin, Marco Jugic, Stuart Heath, Joel Eckert-Ayensa, Andre Radjic, as well as Kalen Boudou, Peter Schall, Marcus Campanile, and Corey Bent. And Dom, we see a couple of new additions into these lineups. What are you thinking for the new guys in the starting lineup?
Well, you know, they're here for a reason. Could be somebody's taking a knock and they're slipping in, but they've proved themselves to their coach that they're up to the challenge. They haven't had the same knocks. They haven't been pushed around enough as much over the last couple of days. They're going to have a bit fresher legs. Not that they didn't have a break day yesterday, but still, those sort of knocks in the cold weather start showing up a little bit more, those deep bruises into the muscles when it's only air ambient temperature plus 2 degrees Celsius out there. You're going to feel those a heck of a lot more. I was just going to say they've got to get involved early, and that's the big thing.
And your officials in this game: Scott Ciccolione, Simon Murgatroy, Phil Thompson, as well as Dave McDonald. And it looks like the Capers will be taking the ball first in those black and orange uniforms, and the Acadia Axemen in their red and blues. Just underway here, Capers taking control. Looks like Rogic, and he's just going to move it back, taken there by Doolin. Goes far side. Just getting some good touches here. There to Peter Schall. You've liked his play so far.
I have. You know, watching Peter Schall, as I was saying the other day, when they were in the extra time, Schall just shut it down in the back. Big man, can get up high, challenges every ball, and does a great job in clearing his lines.
And in that 2-1 final there for the Capers, I asked for your predictions before who was going to score the winner, and you actually did predict Corey Bent had two goals in that overtime frame.
Corey Bent, that free kick that he took was just sublime. Near post, curled it in just inside the post, and on the first goal that he scored, just stepped back, let all the bigger guys sit there, hammer around at the ball, waited for it to come out, and just drilled it into the back of the net.
We'll see our first goal kick here from Nigel Goodwin. He's got a gigantic leg as he gets it out to midfield, a couple of headers, and they must love not playing with the wind here in this one, as Acadia trying to get some good possession here. That's Ryan Paris, and they'll just chip it up, and another header there by Schall. We're going to say his name a lot here in this game, as they look there for Bent, and Bent couldn't get the handle on it. Now going to be grabbed there by Connolly, and Schall, nice little side kick there. Now picked up here by the Axemen. And a good pace so far, and a kick stopped there by the back end of the Capers. Acadia trying to set it up, and now getting the first touch there is Jamie Wilson. Wilson just going to roll it there far side. And another long kick. The header, and maybe an opportunity here as the player was held up. No call there by the official.
Wow, that was, I think they dodged a bit of a bullet there. You can see Acadia's number four, Andrew Snyder, get a hold of the Cape Breton attacker and pull him back a couple of times. Not much into it, but close enough that referee Ciccoloni had a close look at that. So going to have to be careful. Hoping to see more out of Andrew Snyder. You know, he's been sort of invisible back there. And as the MVP of AUS, I hope he plays up to his level today.
In one of the biggest games of his life, certainly you'd love to see the MVP come through, as a good run here for Ekardiensa, as Joel Ekardiensa might have taken a man down there, and a free kick coming here for the Axemen. This game also featuring some of the elite scorers in the AUS, so could see a high-flying affair.
You know, it's good that they're getting going early. You know, Snyder getting involved in, and I think that was Ekardiensa that he actually went in on the first one. Ekardiensa feeling a little bit of retribution, go back after the ball a little bit, and a physical game is a good game. You know, it allows everybody to get involved early. You get warm a little bit quicker when you're in on the tackles.
So going to be picked up there by Paris, and getting a couple touches there, but a bit heavy on the pass. Now grabbed by the Capers, and a good physical battle. One there by Zachary Visser. And trying to penetrate in deep here. Looks like it might be kicked out, and are we going to see a corner kick?
That was a goal kick, and Shally came across and cleared that well off the boot. And as you said, that's a name we're going to be saying a fair bit. You know, the German center back, Shally, he's a powerful man, and wasn't going to back away from that. Going the wrong way towards the ball, was still able to play it off the Acadia attacker.
So we'll get another look at Jamie Wilson here on the goal kick, as we've just passed the four-minute mark in this first half. 0-0 the score. There's a header put on there by Paris, and right out. Throw in coming here for the Capers.
Paris has impressed me the last game they played. He's a strong player. He's sliding back as a defending midfielder and sort of just sitting in front of the back four, and impressive to watch him play.
So we'll see the Capers here. picking it up, and another ball sent out of bounds. And Dom, something I wanted to ask you about is Acadia's only won one AUS championship in their program's history. What's been the change here for this program getting to this elite level?
Well, you know, you start getting a few more. You actually see it all across AUS. A lot more recruiting taking place, international players coming in, a desire to play at a higher level.
As Bent with the shot and missing just near side.
So, you know, you start seeing a few more players coming around, getting players who want to play from other regions coming into the area, knowing that this is very high-level soccer. And it's been really equal across AUS this year. I mean, if you take a look at the point spread between first and sixth, there wasn't a lot there. At any day, any of these teams could have beat each other. It's interesting that at the end of the day, though, we do have 1-2 playing in the final. We have 1-4 playing in the semis. And 1-6, you know, so it's working out the way it should be. So it's a really close program that we have in here.
And want to extend the warmest welcomes as well to any Capers fans and Acadia fans, wherever you may be watching. Thank you so much for joining us here on TV1. It's going to be an outstanding game. It's been a tremendous tournament so far.
And fairly decent turnout, actually, at the pitch, too, for a cold day. There's a few blankets on the sideline and a couple of signs over there, I think, for Acadia fans. But there's some of the UMB players are out there watching the final game as well. And, you know, a few hundred people out watching this game live.
UMB, the defending champions, falling 1-0 to these Acadia Axemen in that hotly contested semifinal. That was a great game to call.
Oh, that was fun to watch. You know, a bit disappointing. I work here at UMB, so it was kind of hard for me. But no, most of the guys on the team. But Katie did a great job, had that one advantage, and took complete control of that one shot back of the net, and it was all over, and they just shut down the back line after that.
And maybe a good look here for the Capers and getting a boot on it. It looked like Corey Cadeau extending out, but a corner kick coming here.
Yeah, good job by Cadeau to get his boot across that as that shot was coming from the right-hand side. It's going to give him a little bit of a stinger on the side of the foot and then a twist of the knee, but good job to get in there to push that back for a corner kick.
And maybe the first dangerous opportunity coming here, and they'll trust the boot there of Joel Ekardiensa to take this one from that far side corner. As we see Corey Bent in the box with that tremendous leaping ability, as it's a long kick and gets over near side now, again popped up and a head on it. Corey Bent now in the area, and a ball going to be just kicked away but still kind of dribbling around and grabbed there by Acadia as the Capers wanted a call. No foul to be found. And some more physical running.
That's a second shout now by Capers for a penalty shot, and that was... player came across and tried to hold that ball up, but referee's just letting them play. Coach doesn't seem to be too perturbed, but he's having a couple of words with the fourth official on the sideline. So the physical play is going to continue, and that's going to bode well for an exciting game.
Yeah, and as long as those calls continue to go the Capers' way as well, the coaching staff will have no problem with it, as Bent popping it up, and a gorgeous bending kick and a rebound given off there, but the ball... now picked up there by Goodwin.
Wow, did Acadia ever dodge a bullet on that one. Goalkeeper Goodwin went up to grab that, and it couldn't get his mitts on it. Dropped to the feet of the Cape Breton player. I think that was Campanelli there who was stood in the middle of the box, and he just whiffed at it.
Yeah, it looked like he just maybe mistimed the jump by a fraction of a second and didn't get enough mitt on it. As now Jamie Wilson... going to show us that leg once more. Sending it to the sky. And he's looking there for Daniels, or that was Bent. And there for Bent. As he lost the handle grab there by Tyler Connolly. And just kicked out there by Shawley. Throw in going to come here from Michael Wilkinson. And a good header put on. Finally settling that ball down there, the Capers. Given back there to Pritchard as he tried the lead pass and couldn't get it up there for the man in the yellow boots. That was Kalen Boudou, also inserted into this starting lineup here for the Capers.
He showed a lot of speed in that last game, and when he came up, he was involved in a lot of plays and good control of the ball. And it's the same with Stuart Heath with the big beard up top. I think he's just waiting to knock those ball onto some of the faster players.
Yeah, Heath, a guy very easy to pick out with that Grizzly Adams-type beard from our vantage point. As Bent back with it. And a good run coming here for Bent as he tried to cut towards the middle and just sending that one out as we invite you to join Bell Alliance TV1's Scott Squires as he chats with Cyril Lunny on CTV's The Sideline Scoop each Monday at 8:40 a.m. Atlantic, 9:10 Newfoundland time. Get up to date on TV1's local sports coverage with Scott and Cyril. That's The Sideline Scoop Mondays on CTV Morning Live Atlantic. As that ball just getting back into the Acadia zone. And we'll see if the Capers can set up some offense. Again, looking for Bent, and he looked like he was just getting in behind the backs there. And now some danger here. A shot put on, and they score. Finding that near side corner, and it looked like Stuart Heath.
Stuart Heath, back post. Good job. Looked across, made sure he was onside. The ball came down to him, took his time, slipped it in past the keeper. Great work.
And head coach Dino Morley must be feeling like a genius right now for keeping him in that starting lineup.
Yeah, you know, it was a smart play. Just Heath just stood there and waited for that ball to come back across. Acadia was sitting here looking to see if that was offside, but now they realized, you know, we kept them on, trying to get the players to calm down, pointing to the fact there's still a lot of time to go. I mean, we're only 11 minutes in, but that's a great start for the speed of Cape Breton.
Now Acadia looking to get some offense of their own going here. Snyder, and that just went off a Cape Breton player, look like, so Visser to throw it in. And a good long throw bouncing now to Daniel Pritchard as he sends it up. And Visser back there still trying to fight it off.
Good play by Heath to keep that in and not allow it to go for a goal kick, but unfortunately turned it over to Acadia in the back.
And it looks like we'll have a foul call here.
Boudou called for a foul on the far side, getting in and getting his foot across it.
So now Acadia, as we wait to see who's going to set up for that kick, looks like Visser. And Visser going to pop that one up. And awaiting it on the header there was Doolin. And the Capers once more. Corey Bent, always dangerous, gets it up there for Campanile.
Campanile just tried to look over to Boudou along the far side, but mistimed his kick.
Now streaking down was Travis Fenning, and just couldn't get there.
Big Shally runs across and keeps him away from the ball, does another great job back there.
So the goal kick here, Jamie Wilson, as we're at the 12:30 mark here in this first half, already 1-0, Capers lead. Getting a good running start here in the booming kick. There's Paris as a foul called, and Acadia gonna have a free kick now.
Sean Langeau got sandwiched in between Campanile and Heath on that one.
So it'll be Michael Wilkinson, and he just sends it back. Now worked over there by Andrew Snyder for Visser. And they try that far side and knocked out once more, throw in coming. Now the throw-in by the Axemen, turned over. And all the way across midfield, but again, just a couple of turnovers here. Rate of play slowing down a bit.
Yeah, it's Cape Breton just trying to force the ball back down. Acadia realizing that they've got to get in hard and strong. Chalet going to be called for a high boot on that one.
Yeah, it looks like the player Travis Fenning looks like he's all right, gets up under his own power, but a great opportunity here for the Axemen.
Dangerous spot for a free kick here. You're going to get some of the bigger men up. You can see jogging in along the back. You've got Michael Wilkinson, and he's wearing the captain's armband.
So it's going to be Visser. Looks like he's wearing orange boots today. And doesn't get a running start, just a good pop-up, and Shawley right there. Now it bounces out. And Acadia still trying to work it towards the box. Bent right there, and Fanning on the kick. He's going to battle with Paris. And Paris winning on that one.
Definitely a size mismatch on that one.
So throwing it into a sea of black jerseys.
There were five Cape Breton players there.
And another throw-in try now, just a bit deeper in. Going to be Michael Wilkinson once more. Finds his man down in deep. That's Cooper Coates. And Coates had the winning goal in that matchup against UNB. They'll need a lot from him here in this one.
Yeah, but that was no problem. That ball, just a soft little cross, and Wilson easy to come out and just gather that, move his players down pitch, and allow them to get ready.
Another thundering kick there. And the Capers can't do much with it, as it looks like they'll actually get a throw in here. Rogic.
I'd like to see more of Rogic as well. He seemed to be a little bit more concerned about some of the fouls that were called against him, that weren't called against him the other day, and sort of was taken out of the play. But he's usually a very good central midfielder. Nice attack by Capers number five there, Jukic, to come in and clear that ball out.
So now Acadia taking it far side. And they'll roll it down. No one there, but in pursuit looks like Berrigan. And he's got Jukic right there as well. So Jukic just going to roll that one out of bounds.
Jukic tried to shepherd that ball out, but the ball bounced off his own chin, and then he just puts it out for a throw in.
And again, headed forward there by the Capers, and maybe going for a run here is Kalen Boudou. Great speed on that player. Another player taken down at midfield, and the foul call's coming in now.
Heath having a chat with referee Ciccoloni on that one. Heath called for the foul just inside of their defensive half.
So it looks like Tyler Connolly, the man to take this boot. And he drives one towards the box, and a good true kick, but right there, the goalkeeper, Wilson.
Shally Wilson stood right there with that, and keeper gave Shally a shout, just told him to bail out, that it was his, and good job, nice take, clean.
Now Rogic, and he stops up, trying to direct traffic here, and just makes a safe play back there for Shally. And just over top of the head, but a good run coming in here, Ekardiansa, and it might have gone out. Just went out right off Ekardiansa.
Yeah, he just, eyes got big and saw the net, and just hammered the shot, drilled it way wide. Might have had a little bit more time, but that ball came over top of Heath. Heath trying to get up for that and just ran onto Ekardiansa's foot. Nice run by Ekardiansa, come from the midfield for that one.
So far it's been all Cape Breton Capers, 1-0 the lead, and really dominating the offensive opportunity category. As another one popped up here by the Axemen. And there's Boudou once more. And a leading pass, just missing the foot there of Heath. And now some good touches there by the Axemen, but turned over and trying to find Heath here. And looking like a handball.
Definitely a handball. Snyder actually hit that one twice. And this is, if that last one was in dangerous position, this one's right in front of the net from about 20 yards out. Good opportunity now for maybe somebody like Bent to hit another one of those free kicks like he did in extra time the other day.
Yeah, and you feel for the guys in the wall right now, as you mentioned, everything. If it hits you, it's going to feel all the much more worse here in this cold.
Yeah, but, big fullbacks, you talk about it after the game. Those are called war wounds at this point in time, and those are a little bit of a badge of honor. If you block the shot from this distance, goalie's going to buy you lunch anyway.
So we'll get a look at the free kick here. The player in the orange boots here, putting it up and right into the breadbasket there of Nigel Goodwin.
Good job by the wall, but great job by Nigel Goodwin to see that one coming in and pick that up no problem and slid behind it, got his body behind it.
That was Joel Ekardiansa on the kick, and now all the way up once again in Capers territory, but they'll have another run. Ekardiansa advancing it forward for Boudou, and Boudou and Paris getting a bit tangled up, but Boudou still keeping control as another one rolling out off a caper. So Acadia really needing to get the momentum tipping in their direction as another foul called and a free kick. Maybe this will be the opportunity.
I don't know. This one's, again, on the side. It's a straight front shot from there. Might be a little bit tight. No weather to really push this ball around. Easy to be able to see it, so I think you'll probably be looking at across the far post. Although he's going to hit this with his left, his right foot, might be looking to curl this in around the wall.
So Tyler Connolly just waiting for the signal here. And he puts it up and headed away, looked like Schale, and bent on the chase and couldn't keep it in.
Nice try by Bent to do that, but again, big Schale in the back holding down the fort.
And the defense really tightening up here for the Capers.
Robson Doolin came across to clear that one out, and he's being evident on this near side as he's coming in and clearing a lot of balls that are just short chips into the defenders.
So Acadia is still just trying to find some penetration here. They've been largely kept to the outside. And once again, cleared away, Paris, and just sailing over his head all the way back now for Snyder. And given off there for Wilkinson. Bent. And that lead pass forward and cleared all the way down and out. As we remind you to watch Inside the AUS for a weekly look at the players and coaches and administrators that make Atlantic University Sport the ultimate student-athlete experience, Inside the AUS is available on demand to Bell Alliant 5 customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401, as well as online at bellalliant.ca/tv1. Bell Alliant 5, three amazing services, one amazing price. Popped up there by Boudou, and a physical play, but no whistle. Another Schale header, and the throw just going to hold up here for Acadia. No need to go too quick here, still plenty of time to play. And once more getting the head on it. That was Andrew Snyder. Or scratch that, Robson Doolin.
Yeah, there's Doolin coming back across again in his defensive positions in the back and just chipping the ball back up.
So Boudou gets it over there for Rogic. And a good run here, back up there for Rogic.
Good switch by Cape Breton. It's been coming up this near side a lot and switch it over, take an opportunity, but now they come back this way.
So we'll give it off to Bent. And Bent with a little space. It looked like it hit the back of the arm there of Paris.
Yeah, but he had his back turned to it. That's ball to hand. A lot of people try to call that as a handball, but
and a good jump there by Heath. And Boudou in pursuit. And maybe an opportunity here. Heath gets the foot on it. And just not enough wood to get it by Goodwin there.
Heath was falling back. I don't think he was expecting that ball to come back off him. And gets another shot on goal. Good for him to be in the right place. It's where you want to see your strikers.
Still keeping his team in it. Nigel Goodwin just waiting for that offensive reinforcement. Now Jamie Wilson, as Wilson sends it to the sky. And missing both players there. Paris. And Paris turning it over to Schale. Now Boudou. And that lead feed there from Eckert Ayensa is almost turned over. And now still that loose ball. Finally sent out, and we'll get a Capers throw.
You can hear Coach of the Year from the Acadia side, Finley McRae, telling his players they've got to be quicker to the ball. It seems right now on those loose balls, Cape Breton much more hungry for them and just trying to get into them faster than Acadia are.
It's one thing you had mentioned. You saw them at the hockey game last night, the team seeming very relaxed and, pretty loose anyway.
Yeah, you know, they were just sat down as a group up in the stands watching the Varsity Reds home hockey game last night. Seemed to be exactly that, just pretty loose, just hanging out as a team and taking some time out of the hotel room, just trying to do something social together, and it was good to see them out there, but, you know, they seemed to be quite relaxed about what was going on.
So a foul called here on Paris, as it's back into play here now. Picked up by Daniel Pritchard. And that long boot, he's got Heath right there, but sailing over his head. And Heath couldn't keep it in. Goal kick coming.
I think Heath's a little bit mad at himself. He looked like he may have been able to wrap his foot around that, but gives a big thumbs up to his right back on that one for a great switch. But it was a smart play by Rajic again, playing the ball across, looking for the open wing, and then allow Heath to run in behind the defenders.
So we'll get a goal kick here as we just approach the 25-minute mark in this first half, 1-0. Cape Breton leads. Sent back, and Boudou on the chase. Another header forward. Just great ball control here by the Capers. Now sent forward there by Heath, and a good run coming here from Eckert Ayansa. Some good one-touch passing. And now Eckert Ayansa towards the goal, and Goodwin once more there.
Goodwin just juggled that at the feet of Heath and picked it up at the last second.
As Schalle falling to the pitch. Given over there to Langell. And just missing Heath once again as Eckert Ayansa taken down.
Cape Breton bench looking for a foul on that. The only one on the Cape Breton colors who didn't seem to be was Eckert Ayansa. He just knew that he didn't get there in time as Snyder pushed that out for a Cape Breton throw.
And again, tremendous officiating so far, knowing when to draw the line of what's a foul and just what's good physical play.
Yeah, again, we talked about this the other day. I mean, it is a contact sport. It's physical play, and so just allowing them to play is fun for everybody. It's more exciting as a game.
So now Heath tried to get that left foot on it, and it just toes the line as Acadia able to not hold it in, but it will be a goal kick.
Good work by Snyder there, showing physical play and just bouncing Heath out of the way and holding up his own position to allow it to go for the goal kick.
So now Goodwin surveying the field. And he'll take it near side. About a 55-yarder there. Good run here from Langell. And trying that lead pass in the defense of Cape Breton, holding strong off the foot of Berrigan. And maybe an open look here. Another great defensive
nice
stand
tackle
by Pritchard. Trying to go middle seam there. And back for Paris. Now Heath. And Heath couldn't get enough on that touch. The pace again really picking up here in this Subway AUS Men's Championship match. Up there for Heath. And Rajic. Rajic maybe going for the cross here and out off the boot there.
Rajic just couldn't get his body around that one, and but it was a great run and nice buildup for Cape Breton around this left side.
And just continuing to expose that defense there of Acadia. And on the Acadia end, what can they do to try and get this offense going and keep the play out of their end?
They got to engage their midfielders more. As I said before, Paris is actually dropping back too far. But if they really want to be able to push, they need to push Paris up higher. When they played against UMB the other day, he was a lot more engaged farther up the pitch. Now, I know that Cape Breton's got some speed that he has to deal with, but still, they need to be able to release him higher up so he can get involved in the attacking play.
And setting it up once more here, the Capers, as Paris was on the defense there, now far side and just stopping up here. Given back for Campanile. And Campanile trying to get it towards the box in the header there. Now Eckert Ayansa, as it was cleared out there by Sean Langell. As Langell went down and he's holding his head. And a player down behind as well here for Acadia. Not a good sign.
Yeah, Pritchard went up and challenged for that header in the middle of the box. And I think there might have been a small collision of heads between Berrigan and Pritchard. And Eckert Ayansa got involved over on the far left side. I don't see who that is down on the field.
It's Corey Cadeau as he was grabbing at the leg area.
But the referee's just saying you don't need the physical crew. Which is good for Acadia, because if he does get any treatment, he's got to go off, and he seems to just be pulling up the sock and going back at it.
Got to love the black and blue effort here, and what's going to be the well, potentially final game of the season for one of these teams, but the other one going to punch their ticket to Guelph for Nationals.
Yeah, it's coming forward and trying to show the injury he's got on his leg or where he's got a scuff mark on his leg from the tackle that I think that Ekadianza got in on him to get that ball across. Referee and the AR didn't really care too much about that. This is a good sign of fair play. Just put the ball back down to the keeper.
And we invite you to visit bellalliance.ca/TV1 for the TV1 live webcast schedule and on-demand content. You'll also get information on TV1 live events available only to Bell Alliant 5 customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401. Bell Alliant 5, three amazing services, one amazing price. As Acadia sending it forward, and maybe some speed here, but Shawley again, the stalwart back there, doing a great job. So they'll try that other side. Cadeau losing the handle and all the way back now. Picked up there by Snyder. And a big long boot. And again, just some high balls here. Trying near side now. Looking there for Paris as Bent with a lot of room to run. And he's got a couple players with him. Heath in the middle as Bent gets around the man. And Goodwin jumping right out, fearless.
You can see Nigel Goodwin, the Acadia goalkeeper, yelling at his winger to not play around with the ball in that and to actually rush at the ball. But good run by Bent. Ball just rolled down his shin for the last touch right into Goodwin's hand. But I mentioned that the other day. Goodwin, powerful goalie and gutsy too, diving at the feet of speedy Bent running at you like that.
So a ball going out of play here. Acadia Axemen to throw it in as we're just at the 31-30 mark in this first half. 1-0. Cape Breton leads off of that goal that they scored early on, just around the 10-minute mark. As that ball sent out of bounds.
Again, Radjic complaining about what happened there. And I think he just needs to be involved in the play a little bit more and just clear the ball out.
So now Shawley once again clearing it here. It's going to be Wilkinson trying to find a man and no one there on that far side, but a good run here from Cadeau. Cadeau, the player who was injured momentarily. Looks no worse for wear. And a rolling ball, staying in play. So Acadia trying to set it up there. Matthew Berrigan as he drives it on net and Jamie Wilson there with the stop.
That's one of the best attacking possessions that Acadia's had going forward there. Two players in the middle of the box and had Wilson not be able to pick that ball up, then it would have definitely run on and a couple of options to be able to put that ball into the back of the net.
So Rogic there up for Heath, and Boudou looking there for Bent, but turning it over. Back there for Rogic as he was taken down. As they're going to assess the free kick here. Rogic leaving it back there for Shawley.
AR just telling Shawley where to set that one up. And again, Rogic in on a hard tackle. Maybe they just know that he will be more interested.
And an opportunity there. Boudou just getting a bit ahead of himself, but gaining control. As he was looking there for Bent, a bit too hard on the pass, but Bent controlling it. And his cross off the head of Heath. Paris able to clear it away.
I think Boudou was looking to try to play that ball back to Radjic, and Bent didn't know that Radjic was behind him and just stepped in the way.
So a run coming here, far side. And once again turned over, Marcus Campanile. The time of possession really staggering here in favor of Cape Breton. Now all the way back deep, Jamie Wilson.
Big punt over the top by Acadia, but nobody there to run onto it. And Wilson take a couple more seconds off towards halftime here and get his players back under control.
So a deep kick. And off the head there of Heath and Bent with an opportunity. Looked like he was offside.
Yeah, the offside flag up on the other side. Great little flick by Heath to try to get that on to Bent. But Bent had run into the back.
Head on down to the UNB tents and go visit the dance team to get your 50-50 ticket.
So a kick coming here for Nigel Goodwin. As he's out a bit deeper here on this one.
Yeah, he's out about 20 yards out, and he's just going to look to hammer that down the pitch.
Off that left foot, trying to find Paris as he got the head on it. And a ball sailing up here near the booth.
Ollie just wanted us to be involved in the game, too.
Yeah, we appreciate his consideration. So a throw-in coming here from Michael Wilkinson. And headed back there by Bent. And Boodoo trying to fight off Paris there. As he sent it forward, looking there for Connolly. And again, just super tight defense on display here from Cape Breton.
Good work by Boodoo to step in front of the Acadia player.
So now Schale off his shoulder. And another high ball. Headed forward by Acadia. And another thundering kick, Bent. Crossing mid-pitch.
Bent just wanted to get that out so they could get organized again. It was a bit scrambly in defense then for Cape Breton, so Bent just slowing this down, allowing his defenders to get back into their regular positions.
So Goodwin sending it to the sky. And Bent again moving it forward there for Boodoo. And a run by Rogic. Up once more for Boodoo and gets it through the legs of the defender. But Boodoo taken down. It's a contact sport, but not that physical.
It was a good move by Wilkinson, good professional foul. He knew that Boodoo had him. He just megged him with the ball and, you know, it was the defender back there. It's manner ball gets through, and in this case the ball got through, but Boodoo wasn't going to be able to continue the run. And it's really not that bad. The foul's out on the corner about 30 yards out, so something that is easily defended.
Looks like we'll see Bent trying to get the kick in play here. There must be some kind of Bent like Beckham reference to be made.
I'm not even going to touch that one.
Bent sending it forward and off the head of Heath and just barely missing the bar.
Heath just put that one over. Nice ball by Bent to get that into the box. And Heath's been collecting a lot of those balls in the air. At the detriment of Snyder, it's been those two going up for the ball in the middle, and maybe that's why they kept Heath in there. They knew full well that Snyder's strong in the air, but he's been doing a great job knocking those balls up and into the back.
So Goodwin, his lead kick, once again headed back by the Capers. Rogic moving it forward once again for Bent. Now there for Paris, and given off there to Wilkinson. Now a free kick on the foul coming here for Acadia.
Yeah, it was a big hit from the back. Doolin tried to run across and take the ball and took a little bit more of Cooper Copes than he did the ball. Referee was right on the spot. Another easy call.
So we reached the 38-minute mark here in this first half. 1-0 Acadia trailing here 1-0 to Cape Breton. As that ball sent out of bounds. Throw in coming here for the Axemen. And still just unable to get any meaningful possessions in Capers territory. Maybe an opportunity here. And we'll see another foul call.
It was offside on the near side. Berrigan tried to sneak in behind the Cape Breton players, but caught by the near side AR.
Goal kick coming here from Jamie Wilson. And gets a good one as Heath once again off his head. as you mentioned, doing a great job of timing those headers, and another one sailing.
That one came closer.
We might be able to walk away with a souvenir as well.
You got to reach out the window, though. It's a long drop from the top of this. You go ahead.
Yeah, not me.
I'll hold your headset.
I appreciate that. As Rogic sending it in. Another header there. And a good attempt there by Campanile. And maybe another opportunity coming here for the Capers. Stuart Heath all over the pitch today. And a lead pass, but couldn't find the man in the area. Now Rogic on the chase and tried to get it there for Bent. Nothing doing. Now back there for Schale. And that one thwarted. Now Pritchard. And that lead feed there for Heath as the defender on him had fallen. And another great play there by Paris. Now the man taken down. That was Boudou. And you hear these Axemen faithful, a lot of them in the stands here trying to get loud and cheer their team on.
Yeah, in the last 5 minutes just trying to support their team. Try to get the ball going forward in any sort of positive movement. That's great to see.
That ball sent out of bounds. Throw in set to come here for the Capers. And just off a shoulder, now picked up by the Axemen. Given there for Paris. Near side, bouncing ball and finding a man. There's Connolly. And Connolly tries the cross. And no one there, just headed away by Daniel Pritchard.
Good communication between the keeper and the defender. He just pointed where he wanted that ball to go as there was an Acadia player at the back post, but poor play by Rogic. Just threw a leg at it and didn't get his body behind the ball to try to stop it. And a great run by the Acadia player to take that ball down to the corner and get it across the net.
And we'll see an Axemen corner kick here. This might be the first one on the game. Not too many so far for Acadia.
No, there's not been a lot of balls down in this area. I think there might have been a couple early on.
So Connolly puts it in play, and the poor kick hit his own man in the back. And nicely cleared away. Throw in coming here for the Axemen.
Robson Doolin getting across again and then just getting in front of the player he was defending.
So throw in. Going to be taken here by the Axemen and getting some good touches, trying to get it towards the box and bouncing around and cleared away. Paris puts it back in play and right onto the keeper, Jamie Wilson.
Another good clearance into the middle of the box by Schale. But again, Paris there to knock that back into the box, but all the Acadia players were still deep at that point in time.
Another deep booming kick and now headed back by the Axemen, Schale. As his lead feed was trying to get to Eckert Ayensa. Now move forward in Eckert Ayensa. Tried to get it on his boots. And a ball put on goal, missing just wide and Bent in pursuit. Able to keep it in and crossing. Another good play there by the Axemen. Now picked up by Doolin as he flipped it forward and no one was there to take it. Cleared away once more by Acadia.
Acadia just seems to be slide on the outside just off the turf as Pritchard goes down, put his boot down, and there's some pavement over there, and he wasn't looking where he put his boot down, and his foot just slid out from underneath of him.
That would be a tough blow here for the Capers as basically everything has gone their way in this first half, but it looks like he's gotten up and
it's good, guys.
Nothing too heavy there for Cape Breton.
No, he's back up. I think just caught him a little bit off guard as he tried to pick that ball up and get it back in.
Yeah, tough on those different textures. As Acadia booming it forward, just passing the 44-minute mark here in this first half. Now Jamie Wilson has a man right in his face.
It's going to be interesting to see if Wilson remembers what he did in that UMB game at late on when he got called for handball, having that kicking the ball outside of his box. He's getting got close there on one, and you know the officiating crew is going to be watching that. They caught it the first time, so they will be looking at it. He does tend to come pretty far out when he's attacking, when he's trying to punt that ball downfield.
So now Acadia getting it across once more and to the defense of the Capers. Goalkeep now sending it way across the half, trying to find Heath there. And Budu now for Rogic. Bent. Back there for Schale. So into extra time here as we reach the 45-00 mark. We'll see how much they'll put up. Not a lot of stoppages here in this first half. So Acadia, as we heard Finley McRae just shouting, keep composed on the ball, as they've been turning it over quite a bit here in this first half. So Rogic, little stutter step and finding some space. Now getting it there for Bent, and Bent with some room. And rolls out off of his boot.
Bent, for some reason or another, took that ball on his right foot. If he would have taken the left in stride, he would have been in. Great ball by Rogic to switch it over to the left-hand side and get an opportunity for Cape Breton to attack late in the half.
So Nigel Goodwin will need to get a good leg on this kick to try and find some offense. Gets a running start, and that'll bring to an end the first half here. 1-0, the Cape Breton Capers leading over top of the top-ranked Acadia Axemen. And Dom, what were your thoughts on that first half of play?
You know, I thought Cape Breton did exactly what they needed to do, what we talked about at the beginning. Acadia was sitting back a little bit, and Acadia just kept on pushing that ball forward, playing it to feet, attacking, getting the ball out wide, using the wings, and whipping it back into the middle of the box. Cape Breton keeps on doing that, I don't see anything but positive for the way that they're going.
What sort of adjustments would you make if you were on the Acadia coaching staff heading into the next 45?
They've got to engage the midfield a little bit more. As I said, they've got Paris dropping back, and Paris is a beast. And if he can get that ball higher up the pitch and he attacks it, it's hard to take him off the ball. He can get control higher up and be able to attack deeper, so they've got to move him in a little bit more on the attack.
As we're just awaiting Roger Surrett with the head coach, Dino Morley, with the Capers, and he's got to be feeling pretty good about that first half of football.
Yeah, you know, he's got to be a little bit content with it, but you never sit back on that one.
As we have Roger Surrett with Dino Morley down on the sideline.
Coach Morley, 45 minutes gone by. You kept possession for most of that first half. Certainly you want to keep that going in the final 45.
Yeah, I think the possession's coming because we're winning the battles and the fight. And we're here. The boys are determined today. I think we're showing composure in the final third, creating enough chances. And we wish we could have got another one there, but we'll come out and keep going.
I'm sure there's going to be some adjustments being made, and you got to take the time to go upstairs, make those adjustments. Good luck in the second half.
Yeah, good. I think we just got to remain calm and keep playing football.
All right, we'll be back in a few moments. 1-0 for Cape Breton against Acadia on a goal by Stuart Heath in the 11th minute. We'll be back after these messages.
It's AUS football season, and Bellaline 5 TV 1 has you covered. Strong rivalries run deep as the X-Men, the Mounties, the X-Men, and the Huskies battle it out all season long. And with 5 TV 1, you won't miss a game. For hard-hitting, adrenaline-pumping AUS football, there's only one. Bellaline 5 TV 1, live on Channel 1 at 4:01. Football so intense, you won't know what hit you. Watch AUS football presented by Subway, the official fuel of Atlantic University Sport.
These are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs. And these, wait for it, are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs with no artificial colors, flavors, or preservatives. It's a big change you can feel good about. And it's how we're leading our commitment to feel good, taste good food. Make all your sandwiches come true at Subway.
The CFL and our partners at Football Canada want to make sure we keep growing, promoting, and investing in a safe game.
Hit!
Football Canada now requires all amateur coaches to be safe contact trained by 2017. By creating a standard of safety for all in our football community, we're making an already great game even better. Make sure your youth coach is safe contact trained, because making a safe game means making a better game.
Sweat. It says I was here. I worked here. It says I only have so much to give before I have to take. What I lose, I want to get back. Sweat says, I earn this. Gatorade, created to help replace what you sweat out.
And we are back here at the BMO Center halftime at the 2016 Subway AUS Men's Soccer Championships, with the Acadia Axemen trailing 1-0 against the Cape Breton Capers on a goal at the 11th minute by Stuart Heath. Now, to my right, that is John Richard, athletic director here at the University of New Brunswick, and organizing this type of tournament, John, always takes a lot of manpower, a lot of hours to organize a pristine event, and you guys put on a great event all weekend long.
Thanks very much. Yeah, I mean, it takes a lot of hands on deck with volunteers and with our staff, but fortunately we have some experience. We hosted the national championship on this turf a couple years ago, so not that there's eight teams here, there's only six, but we certainly have some experience doing it.
And having that familiarity of hosting high-caliber championships, not only in soccer, but in other sports as well, such as hockey and basketball, when you have the facilities, it is much easier to bring these types of championships here to the provincial capital of Fredericton.
Yeah, I mean, we're very fortunate in the support we get from our administration, and now with the Curry Center that we have and our Aiken Center beside us, and now with BMO Center here, the turf, we can host those events, and it's something that we've tried to do. We bid on a lot of championships at the national level, and fortunately the national organization has, what was the CIS, has entrusted us to host those, so we certainly feel very fortunate to do so.
When you look at everything in general, although that you guys are hosting it here at the AUS Championships, but it bodes well for the entire AUS in general that you guys can hold a great event, and it also sets the parameters for other universities to hold up to your standards.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of my colleagues, I would say, do a great job of hosting too. I mean, this event on the women's side this weekend is in Cape Breton, and the numerous AUS championships in Cape Breton that I've attended or our teams have attended are very well done too. And I mean, there's all kinds of great hosts in the AUS, and we share a lot of ideas. And but certainly, I feel very blessed to have the group that we do have. And like you said, it doesn't really matter what the sport is. A lot of our volunteers are the same volunteers. And this year when we host the U Sports National Championship in men's hockey, it'll be a lot of the same volunteers that we had last year when we hosted the women's basketball championships down at the Curry Center. So a good volunteer is a good volunteer is a good volunteer. So we certainly tap into them.
And when you got that pool that you can dip into, like those regulars, you know what to expect of them at any given time. You know, when they come in, you already set the standard.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we know what they've done before and how committed they are, and getting new blood is good too. So there's always a crop that are new doing the championship, and the excitement they bring is great too. And like I said, we share a lot of ideas too. I mean, our executive crew of men's hockey this upcoming year spent a day with the Halifax crew from last year here last month in Halifax, just sharing ideas, and they were very open to sharing the 2 years they went through at Scotiabank Center hosting men's hockey. So there's no secrets. It's just sharing ideas and trying to get better every time.
Now, seeing the high quality of soccer that we've seen here all weekend long at the BMO Center, certainly when you look at these athletes, it's feather in their caps, and also to the programs that are here for the weekend. We've seen great soccer all weekend, and this game is no different.
Yeah, I know. I mean, it's incredible. We've had the pleasure of being at the last four national championships, our men's team, and Cape Breton's been with us two or three times, and they're always a contender, and Acadia finishing first out of the 10-team league this year, and we had a heartbreaking loss to them the other Friday night, 1-0, but the league is so tight, and there's so much parity, and I'm sure both these teams will represent the conference very well next week in Guelph.
Oh, I'm certain about that, that these two teams going to Guelph next weekend will certainly shine a positive light on the AUS. But when you look at events like this, going into the future with UNB soccer, future still looks bright with Miles Pinsent at the helm.
Yeah, no questions. Like I said, we've had Miles has guided his team to four straight national championships, and unfortunately we just fell short Friday night, getting a fifth straight. But, you know, at the banquet on Friday, we only recognize one graduating athlete, so he'll have most of his team back, and I like his crew, and I mean, hopefully we're right back in this thing next year.
Well, John's going to be an interesting Final 45 coming up here against Acadia and Cape Breton. Thank you very much for taking your time and organizing a pristine event here in on the UNB campus.
Thanks for having me.
That was John Richard, the athletic director here at the University of New Brunswick. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back with the Bell Alliance Plays of the Week.
These are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs. And these, wait for it, are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs with no artificial colors, flavors, or preservatives. It's a big change you can feel good about. And it's how we're leading our commitment to feel good, taste good food. Make all your sand wishes come true at Subway.
The CFL and our partners at Football Canada want to make sure we keep growing, promoting, and investing in a safe game.
Hit!
Football Canada now requires all amateur coaches to be safe contact trained by 2017. By creating a standard of safety for all in our football community, we're making an already great game even better. Make sure your youth coach is safe contact trained, because making a safe game means making a better game.
We are back here at the BMO Center in Fredericton, New Brunswick, on a goal by Stuart Heath at the 11th minute that gives the Cape Breton Capers a 1-0 lead against the Acadia Axemen in this 2016 Subway AUS Men's Soccer Championships. It is that time again. It is time for the Bell Alliance Plays of the Week.
Feel better, oh, feeling better than I'd ever felt. Only time will tell.
Yeah.
And welcome back, friends. The score at the half, the Capers leading the Axemen 1-0 here in the Subway AUS Men's Soccer Championship. I'm Mike Specht alongside Dom Blakely. And Dom, what are you thinking here for this second half?
You know, I'm looking forward to a strong second half. Acadia's got to come out hard and has got to try to get into the back line of Cape Breton. Cape Breton just needs to continue doing exactly what they did in the first half. Push forward hard, get Heath involved, get Boodoo playing balls down and working hard to be able to release some of the wingers and getting Bent involved.
Yeah, that first goal scored there by Acadia was absolutely brilliant by Heath. What did you see on that one?
You know, Heath's been holding the ball up well and just got that shot on net really strong.
And we are going to send you to the Players of the Week here on TV1, the Subway Player of the Week on the women's side, Colleen Wilson out of Dalhousie. She's a women's cross-country runner out of Ancaster, Ontario, in her fifth year and studying oceanography. And on the men's side of things, Calvin DeWolf out of St. Effects, also men's cross-country out of Bridgewater, Nova Scotia, in his fourth year, and he's taking a BA. As we're going to send it down to the sideline, Roger Surrett is with Finley McRae.
All right, I got Finley McRae here, head coach for Acadia. Quick adjustments to be made in the second half. You guys got to get the ball more.
Yeah, attitude adjustment. Guys have got to win this.
All right, good luck.
Thank you.
Good luck in the final 45. Back upstairs.
He said the guys have to win this, and he's calling his players out. They're not really showing a lot of jump to get to the first and second ball.
So Acadia trying to get something going here. That ball rolling out. As we'll see Corey Cadeau throw it in.
Camp and Isle just getting stuck in on a tackle there at the beginning. And I think there was one substitution that came in. I just saw the board come up. Joel Young for Acadia came in and replaced Zach Visser.
And Visser has been starting all tournament long, but we'll see if Young can add the spark that the Axemen need here as Heath trying to get it past Paris there as they work it along to that back end. And a header forward there by the Capers. It's a little bit of a feeling out period here in these first couple of minutes. 1-0 the score as both of these teams will be heading to Nationals in Guelph, but only one will have the swagger of that AUS championship banner.
Yeah, and the higher seed going in, and also next year hosting AUS championships. So, you know, that one of them, both of them, making it to the U-Sport to National Soccer Championships. But it's good to see though that they're battling strong here at the beginning of the second half. It's already Acadia's getting after a few more balls. I think it's going to bode well for the second half.
Whatever Coach McRae said in that locker room might be working here.
Listening to him on the sideline, I don't think it was said in a gentle voice. He didn't sound happy, and you could see it in the first half, the way that he was talking to his players, demanding more of them.
So the Axemen trying to respond here and again sending it out of play. Throw in coming here for the Capers. That's Daniel Pritchard.
Pritchard played a strong first half, taking a lot of balls down.
Just going to be worked along here. Advance forward there by Campanile. And he finds his man on the far side. That's Bent. And Bent with some finesse. Getting around his man and a good head of steam. And the cross in front, ball popped up. And right there, Nigel Goodwin.
Wow, what a great play by Bent to get around the defender. And the ball comes through. And you could see Heath holding his head. He wasn't expecting that ball to come in. Just looked out to Bent. Gave him a thumbs up. It was a strong attack in, and good job by Bent to get that ball in, but not punished.
Once again, cleared out there by the Capers as they were close to getting a bit more breathing room. And Acadia still looking to respond, now picked up. That's Eckert Ienza. And sent forward now, Campanile. And getting it back once more for Bent, going back to the well there, looking forward for Radjic as he was taken down. And off the back there of Bent, and taking a friendly bounce there for the Capers before being shipped up.
That was a good take again by Cape Breton's number four, Robson Doolin, and Doolin came across his own teammate, and he's been hungry to get those balls back into play quickly.
So Joel Eckert-Ianza, once again, a little finesse move as he was taken down and holding on to that leg, it looks like. Hopefully he's all right.
Yeah, smile on the face of Sean Langell as he came across the body as Eckert-Ianza tried to spin back around with it, and sometimes you end up hurting yourself on plays like that.
Joel Eckert-Ianza, who had 9 goals in the regular season here for these Capers, looks like he's all right and might be the one to take the free kick.
Yeah, it's just over 30 yards out.
As we get a look at the AUS All-Stars here, there's Evan Barker out of UNB, Andrew Snyder out of Acadia, Daniel Pritchard out of Cape Breton, Mark Ashley out of UPI, and Alex Taylor on St. Effect. So those are your defenders. And big congratulations to all those players.
Great to see those AUS first All-Stars out there. And that was one of them stood over top of the ball there. One of the midfielders, Eckert-Ianza, just put that ball wide of the near post. Good free kick, but just not on target.
So we'll get a kick here from Goodwin. And a header there from Paris.
Again, Paris strong in the midfield.
Yeah, looks to have a bit more jump already, as that ball might have hit a hand but missed. Now picked up there by Berrigan. And trying that near side seam. And out off the foot of Matthew Berrigan.
Again, Pritchard strong, gets back behind the ball, looks to clear it down the line. Nothing fancy about it, just put it out. See if he can pick out Heath, who can flick it into the middle or get it to the feet of Boudou.
Capers throw in. Going to come here, Pritchard, as he sends a long one. And Heath again, a good header on it, but Paris is right there. And now taken here by the Axemen. Near side, and looked like it went out off a Caper, so they'll try the quick throw in here, and actually that'll maybe change hands, so they'll slow it down and give it off there for Corey Cadeau,
who just took a spill on a tackle from Heath and was not too happy about the fact of the no call.
And that heavy-footed touch there by Berrigan. Another turnover resulting to the Axemen.
Finley McRae still pacing inside the technical area, asking more and more from his players as the time starts winding here.
Acadia in pursuit of just their second AUS championship as a program, and you know, Coach McRae coming in as this top seed is has that fire burning inside to get it.
He does, but, you know, Dino Morley, coach for Cape Breton, as you could hear Athletic Director John Richard for UMB saying that that UMB men's team had gone to a few nationals and they'd been working together. They want to go in and first. They want to be there. They want to take that position where they've been in second place and having to play the higher-ranked team. Cape Breton knows what it takes to get there. They've seen it, and so both coaches pushing their teams as hard as they can.
Yeah, and Cape Breton undergoing a couple of heartbreaking losses in recent years, so certainly wanting to make those errors right and doing good here with the 1-0 lead as another ball popped up and getting in behind Schale there in the header, and they score.
It's in the back of the net, and there we go. That was Andrew Snyder didn't run away from that ball and nodded it over top.
And the goalkeeper, Jamie Wilson, upset with himself, had his head in his hands, just missing on that jump as that high ball, doing a little rainbow action, and in behind him as we get another look at this one, the high ball popped up, and Snyder getting the header on it.
Yeah, you know, we said that before, the MVP, you needed him to step up a little bit and get involved, and there it is, early in the second half. We've got 11 minutes in the first half, 8 minutes in the second half, and we got a game going down the end line here.
And you can hear that crowd getting back into it as well. Very vocal and a ton of emotion on that Axemen bench as well. So 1-1 the score at the 53-minute mark into the second half. Don't go anywhere.
You got to wonder where the Cape Breton defense were on that one.
Now picked up here by Bent, And Bent making a move as the offense has looked great here for Cape Breton as we got our first ball sailing into the parking lot.
Yeah, the Acadia fans happy that the ball's moving along, but good job by Bent to get the ball in and out of play. And he's got around the defender again. Just went through five defenders.
And a low ball blocked away, and now Paris able to clear it out. Gotten back there for Pritchard. And Pritchard, couple of good moves, and Ekardiansa tried to advance it forward for him. And cleared out, a throw in deep, coming here for the Capers.
Acadia defenders, midfielders getting mad at each other over not communicating properly, letting that ball go over the end line. Referee didn't like where that throw-in was taken. He's got to take it farther back down the pitch. But, you know, Cape Breton's responded well. Bent just dancing out of the end line with that ball was just something of beauty to watch.
Yeah, and what a game we're in for the rest of the way if both of these offenses are wide awake. So the Pritchard throw set to come here. He's got Boudou down low. And he'll just try the high percentage play, getting it back there for Robson Doolin. Now for Chalet, the defender that was beat on that last goal by Snyder. And a nice ball popped up. Goodwin right there and able to get it in the mitts.
Good job by Heath to get up in his grill on that one, but great focus by Goodwin just to be able to maintain possession of that ball going to strong hands.
And we invite you to watch the East Coast Sports Show to get up to date on what's happening across the TV1 sports landscape. The East Coast Sports Show is available on demand to Bell Alliant 5 customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401, as well as online at bellalliant.ca/TV1. So the ball sent forward now by Acadia, and they got a man streaking in, trying to battle with Chalet there. On the run there, that was Travis Fenning. And great pressure here by the Axemen.
Yeah, I think that scoring that goal has woken the Axemen up a little bit, which is good to see. Cape Breton's going to have to weather a bit of a storm.
So now a run there by Bent. But we'll get a foul call and a free kick coming here as Marcus Campanile trying to have a chat with the official.
Yeah, referee Ciccoloni was a little bit slow to get to the whistle on that one, so nobody knew exactly where that came up.
As we get another look at that goal, and Chalet just kind of caught in no man's land, chasing after that ball. And a great effort on the head there by Snyder. So the free kick pending here. And a ball sent into the area, and Chalet clearing it away. But a corner kick now coming, and it'll be Tyler Connolly to take it.
Yeah, Travis Fenning a little bit upset at himself for actually not getting a better foot on that, but Chalet marked him well, managed to get it out, but corner kick coming up now.
So the Connolly kick, and a high arcing ball, and again another head put on it, and what do you know, Stuart Heath right there to knock it away.
Pritchard and Heath fighting over who was going to head that one out on that clearance.
So now Acadia. This is Fenning. And Fenning trying to connect on the pass, and a goal kick now going to come here for the Capers.
Good run in by Cooper Coates, but just couldn't get around it. I don't know if there was a little bit of contact on that, but if it was, good defensive play to force Coates to push that ball wide.
Good to see Cooper Coates trying to get involved here as he had a bit of a quiet first half.
Yeah, it's good to see the midfielders engaging more, and as I said, it's what they needed to do was to push them farther up the pitch and get involved more in the offense.
So now the Wilson kick, and meeting the head there of Paris. Once again headed forward, but finding the boot of Heath. Now Ekardiansa, as he finds Pritchard to Boudou. Ekardiansa. And Paris able to get his boot on that one. And we are approaching the 60-minute mark here in this Subway AUS Men's Championship Final.
Finley McCray yelling at his team to get up the pitch and chase that ball. Only one man running for it. Coach McCray not happy with that effort.
Another one popped up and sent out by the Axemen defense. So it's going to be Daniel Pritchard. And going to find his man, Shalley. And looked like it got away from him as he tried to find Bent, and actually Bent doing a great job of tracking that ball that went short. Now a run coming here from Bent, and he's taken down hard.
Referee's got to be going to his pocket for that one, but great run by Bent to actually get to a ball that Shalley mishit, beat two players, and then sent off down the line.
Yeah, and if you're the defender, that might be a card that you have to take, because that's a very speedy player and you don't want to get beat.
Oh yeah, I know. If Bent got past him, you can see this being replayed here. Bent running at the defender. He's already by him, so knows full well he's got to take him down, because there was not much between him and the box and the goal at that point in time.
That card going to Sean Langell. And a free kick coming in deep, but kind of from a bad angle. We'll see what they can do with it. And a nicely headed away ball, but quickly taken there by Bent, and Paris able to knock it off his boots. Now back down low there for Boudou, and he avoids the tackle there by Paris. And that cross couldn't find a man. Nicely cleared out by Acadia. So another ball sent out of play. Goal kick coming here from Goodwin. And high to the sky. Now with the Capers, as you hear Coach McCray shouting, "Come on, we want that second one," really propelling his team forward. Sometimes that's what you need.
Well, you know, I mean, we know he's engaged, and sometimes the players seem to be switching in and switching out, and he's asked a certain amount out of his players to be involved in every play, and he's already doing it, and you can tell he's kicking every kick and heading every ball with them.
So now the Capers trying to find some offense of their own. We knew that one goal likely wasn't going to do it here in this one with these two potent offenses. Pritchard. And he popped that one up looking for Heath, and he scores!
Heath into the back of the net, standing alone, and just easily buries that one to the back post. Great ball in by Pritchard, but Heath being up for the headers all game long.
And it was a beauty of a cross as well. Not sure who it was on the pass there, but Heath.
That was Pritchard putting that one in.
And again, it just seemed like his forehead's been a magnet all game long, all tournament long, and gets his second of the game.
You know, watching Heath up there, he can climb for a ball. He's in the right place at the right time. Second goal of the game, and he celebrates with his teammates on the end line. But great ball in by Pritchard, and Pritchard's been getting a lot of those back into the box.
So it is a 2-1 score here. Capers getting that second one, but as we've seen here in this game, the lead isn't safe as these Axemen trying to work it up, and a nice kick trying to find the man getting in behind the defense and heading it away there. That was Marko Jukic.
Yeah, good work by Jukic. If that ball had got over top of his head, Acadia was in behind.
So that ball going to roll out, and a corner kick coming here for the Axemen. And it looked like a player had kicked that ball away, so they're going to pull out the yellow card and giving that to Daniel Pritchard.
Yeah, Pritchard kicked it away, just trying to waste a little bit more time, although it's a bit too early for that. There's still 27 minutes to go plus any stoppage, but referee right on top of that. No need for that at this point in the game, especially when Pritchard really hasn't put many feet wrong in this game.
So another glorious opportunity coming here for the Axemen. All three goals in this one coming off of headers and into the box and a head on it, but just high.
You can see Heath holding his head. That ball skipped through. Nobody touched it except for the streaking Acadia player at the back post, and he just put it wide. I don't think he was expecting that ball to get to him on his run, and it really shouldn't have. That should have been dealt with by somebody in the middle of the box.
So now the Capers can't do anything on offense. Axemen trying for another run here, and that ball just getting out of bounds. A throw in coming here for Cape Breton.
Heath is trying to get his teammates just to calm down and play their game. You can see him gesturing just with the pushing the palms down, get the guys back in and focusing.
As we invite you to join Bell Alliance TV1's Scott Squires as he chats with Cyril Lunny on CTV's Sideline Scoop each Monday at 8:40 a.m. Atlantic, 9:10 a.m. Newfoundland time. Get up to date on Bell Alliance TV1's local sports coverage with Scott and Cyril. That's the Sideline Scoop Mondays on CTV Morning Live Atlantic.
Strong play by Paris there to hold bent up. Good battle, nice little flick on by Heath.
So we're just reaching the 65-minute mark here in this second half. And 2-1 the score. You got to love the way that the Capers responded after giving up that tying goal.
Yeah, they kept their composure and looked to get those balls, continued to keep their play going. And it's just a credit to the way the coaches got them set up on the pitch.
Now that deep kick, and Nigel Goodwin once again there. You got to admire his ability to track the ball.
Yeah, well, I think you have to with Heath coming in on you like that. You know, Heath and Pritchard looking again down to see if they can get another ball in the middle.
So here is Campanile sending that over for Doolin and back for Pritchard. Pritchard, who had just taken a yellow card moments ago. That deep ball and rolling out of bounds.
Yeah, Ekerdayensa wasn't going to get to that. He knew that the Acadia defender was going to be between he and the ball.
That was Joel Young in pursuit there. But we'll get a goal kick coming here from Nigel Goodwin. As he's going to lean into that one. And a nice header put on there by Boudou. Lead pass trying to find Paris. And getting it up there, running with it, Berrigan.
Good tackle by Pritchard to get his foot in.
And some big contact there. The player going down, Corey Cadeau. That's the second time in this game he's come up a bit worse for wear. Looked like he just took a head-on-head collision.
Referee's reaching into his pocket to give Ekerdayensa a card on that one.
We got a replay on that, and yeah, strong collision.
It looked like Ekerdayensa was playing the ball more. You can see just played straight through the ball. Didn't even go for it. Turned his back a little bit too.
Yeah, especially that's a tough play with the player leaning in towards the contact as he was trying to head it away.
Corey Cadeau doesn't seem any worse for wear as he walks back out onto the pitch.
Yeah, just a stinger, and in this cold weather, like you mentioned, it starts to hurt a little longer than it maybe normally would. As a ball taken here by the Capers. Now with two players garnering yellows. And a rolling ball out, throw-in coming here to the Axemen.
Campanile dribbled the ball out into danger, didn't see the second Acadia player behind him.
And Chalet able to clear it out, but not too deep as a kick blocked there. And Bent jumping up and over top of the man to head that away. Now a lead feed and finding Boudou in those yellow boots. And a great header there by Pritchard. And it looked like Ekerdayensa a little upset that that one went out.
Yeah. Cadeau looking to get back at Campanile on that one. Tried to come through that ball, but
that one going off the side of the foot of Chalet. And a nice header there by Samuel Gillis. Now over for Bent. Acadia to throw it in. Tyler Connolly. and just going to roll back here. Another deep drive and looking there for Stuart Heath. Good header forward.
Good tackle by Bent to get his foot in and come away with that ball.
It's now picked up here by Boudou, and Boudou puts it on goal, and a big stop made there by Nigel Goodwin.
Boudou quick and turns around and looks at the net and tries to go for the far corner, try to curl that in. Great play by Nigel Goodwin to get back across and push that wide.
Launching at it like a missile as we'll get a look at it here. Boudou spinning around and gets a true boot on it. Beauty stop.
Yeah.
So the corner kick in, and Paris couldn't get enough foot on it. Grabbed there by Goodwin. It's now up the seam, and an offside just barely called there to Acadia. Looks like a sub set to check in here any moment as well, and it's going to be Jordan Fabry. Looking like he's warming up. And it's Daniels coming in for Eckerd Ayensa.
Eckerd Ayensa, after he picked up that yellow card, you got to be careful with it. If, you know, oh no, sorry, I guess it wasn't Eckerd Ayensa. Yeah, Eckerd Ayensa got that yellow card there. And you could see in guessing, Dimitri Daniels played really well in that game the other day, and he's going to take a position similar to what Paris did in terms of playing more of a defensive. He did play the other day more of that defensive holding midfielder.
And we see two players getting ready to check in as well for Acadia. So that is Jordan Fabry and Spencer Buck, two players that started the first game here for Acadia, and now going to check back in with some fresh legs.
Yeah, strong, fresh legs at this time in the game, 20 minutes to go. Try to see if you can get some players who can run at the back line.
So that Acadia throw-in. Booted. Looks like it might go into the parking lot. It will.
Yeah, it's about three rows deep on that one.
And now the players subbing in, so they'll take out Tyler Connolly and check in Fabry. And the other player coming out, it's going to be Langille. So Fabry and Buck in there for Langille and Connolly.
Yeah, the Langille had come in to actually sub in for Buck in the first game, and they've given those positions up, subs in quickly and getting ready now to get right back at it.
And Buck out of Quispam Sis, so very close here to the stadium in Fredericton, probably has some family watching on.
Yeah, it's a good chance that they would have made their drive up from just outside of St. John, an hour away. So Buck, familiar with this pitch, would have played on it if he probably played for Fundy teams down in St. John. So a foul there on a tackle.
As we're just awaiting the kick here, and it goes deep. Bent just not tall enough there, but he had a good jump.
Yeah, and the ball back into the parking lot.
So we got the turkey. Three balls into the parking lot here in this second half.
That ball never came in on the throw-in.
And a good strong throw, but knocked away there by Acadia. And the Capers trying to find that third goal here, but Goodwin able to get it.
Shelley looking to pick out Boudou, who was wide open on this far side, but he couldn't get it far enough. Nice flick by Paris.
So that was moved forward there by Rajic. No one in the area. So it'll be a throw in deep in Axemen territory.
Bit early to start trying to pick out that far corner with that. Nobody up there for Cape Breton.
So Cadeau set to throw it in and turning it over immediately. Heath, the one touch pass, trying to find Boudou. And Heath taken down as he had two defenders around him.
Good work by Heath to try to move that ball forward and to get the free kick. Again, in another dangerous place, just 20 yards outside of the 18. Marcus Bent. We know what he can do with the ball from this distance.
And we'll...
Sorry, Corey Bent.
See what he can do here. As he goes about 5 yards back of the ball, going to get a good running start in here and popped up into the box and just off the head there. It looked like Campanile coming forward.
Yeah, Campanile climbed well for that ball. Good job on getting it across and a high five going across between the two players on the way through.
So Nigel Goodwin looking to drive it deep here. And it goes well off his boot, far side, and headed forward. Bent once again advancing it forward. Now just back there for Goodwin. As we invite you to watch Inside the AUS for a weekly look at the players, coaches, and administrators that make Atlantic University sport the ultimate student-athlete experience. Inside the AUS is available on demand to Bell Alliant 5 customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401, as well as online at bellalliant.ca/TV1. Bell Alliant 5, three amazing services, one amazing price. We've got a 2-1 score here, Cape Breton leading over top of Acadia. And Dom, it's still a lot left to play here.
There is, you know, Cape Breton still starting to get stuck in. You can see Bent getting a little bit more space to move around, and Acadia bringing on some fresh legs up front. So with just under 15 minutes to go, it's going to be an exciting finish to this.
Still haven't seen a lot of touches yet for Fabry and Buck, who are into this game. You know, they want to get involved early and start to get loose.
Yeah, Cape Breton's going to do what they can to try to keep the ball up at the other end of the pitch and get those fresh legs just to cool down a little bit with the rest of everybody else and maintain some possession up in the zone. Heath trying to just dribble around people.
So the Campanile corner, high and arcing, went off the skull there of Shawley.
Yeah, Shawley and Heath in the same position looking for that ball. Not enough communication between your center back and your striker there.
Another goal kick approaching here for Goodwin. As we just reach the 76-minute mark. Deep drive. And a great job there by Daniels, who had checked into this game, wearing those lime green boots on the far side. Run coming here from Pritchard. And Pritchard was knocked off the ball, throw-in now pending here for the Capers.
Yeah, Pritchard getting in and Corey Cadeau coming at him to take the ball off his foot. Pritchard okay, just to slow down the walk up to get the ball, keep the ball in that Acadia zone. Make sure they've got to go at least 60, 70 yards to try to score.
And that one just thrown out. Now a goal kick here. And Goodwin going very quickly here, recognizing that time's starting to wind down.
I'm not sure why he chased that ball when the ball person on the other side of the net had a ball for him.
Yeah, it might have killed a little more time than he wanted. And he gets a good drive on that one near side, trying to find Paris. And a nice leap and header forward there for the Capers. And now sent up there by Doolin. Good run here by Heath. And knocked out. Looks like a throw-in coming here deep in the Acadia end once more.
Yeah, good work by Joel Young to get back behind that ball, but he misplayed it the first time, saved himself by putting it out for a throw-in. As he had the dangerous Heath, who's managed to maintain possession inside quite a few times.
Yeah, likely playing some of the best football of his career here in this AUS championship. High and across midfield. Now a good run coming here by Fenning. And Fenning just couldn't connect with his man. He was trying to find Cooper Coates.
Yeah, Chalet just again cleaning up in the back. As Rajic was in a bit of a battle on that far side, but Chalet just getting the ball out and allowing his defenders to get back and join him inside the box.
So we'll have a corner kick coming here. Corey Cadeau set to take it. He's taken a couple of knocks. here in this game. And just a bit of a line drive header on it. And a high boot. It's going to land in bounds. We'll see if Acadia can keep it in, and they'll just send it out.
Yeah, it's almost like Andrew Snyder's been now assigned to mark Heath when he can, when the ball's going forward.
So now just going to roll it back to the goalkeeper, Wilson. As he led it up and just getting right on the foot there of Coach Dino Morley.
Nice touch by Dino. Get that ball back into play quickly.
Yeah, he still got it as they lead it up and another header there. Ball still just up in the air and Heath whiffing on it. Maybe the only misstep that he's had in this game so far. He's the man with the two goals here for the Capers.
Yeah, Heath just trying to backheel it over, understanding that wasn't going to be able to do much with the ball, but just wanted to get it into the back.
Some more fresh legs here. So Ryan Rodenizer in the game for Berrigan. And now checking in as well here for Cape Breton. Or not quite, they'll give him a minute. So now getting an early touch here, Rodenizer. And just a miscue there by Acadia.
Yeah, Dimitri Daniels got stuck in on a tackle and the free kick coming up for Acadia. Looks like that might be Nguessen coming in, getting ready to come in, and he was a starter the other day.
And a good jump for this team once he does come in. We'll see him here now. And Stuart Heath, as he's really riling his troops up as he checks out of the game. Two goals there for Heath, and Nguessen jumping in.
Yeah, it's Heath might be at the end of his wind on this one, but Nguessen's going to be playing up high.
And a deep ball put into the box, and coming away with it, Jamie Wilson.
Yeah, right in the mix there again was Andrew Snyder, but he was surrounded by four or five black shirts. Keeper missed the first one, but managed to be able to get a hold of it on the second bounce.
So we've just passed 80 minutes here in the second half. Only nine and change to go, and Acadia trails by a goal. Picked up here by Buck. Finally able to get a touch here and looking fit as he sends it forward. A couple of nice passes, but missing on the look there for Fabry. Now Nguessen getting it over there for Daniels and picked up by Bent. And Nguessen taking contact as it's driven deep and a good sprint there, grabbed by Bent. So Bent able to create space for himself, as good as anybody in this AUS. And just taking his time, holding on to it here as the clock continues to wind, and back there for Daniels. Now getting it there for Doolin. And Doolin falling to the turf. Looks like a free kick. Now here for the Capers.
Yeah, Doolin, they great play again by Bent to hold on to that ball in the corner. Just played it back to Dimitri Daniels, and you know, Cape Breton just trying to hold on to it as long. Acadia, they can't score if they don't have possession of the ball, so Cape Breton's going to do everything they can to maintain possession for the next 8 minutes plus stoppage.
Doing a masterful job so far, and Doolin looking to get the kick here as we see a man sprinting to the sideline. That's Fabry.
Yeah, Fabry is obviously, his shin's bleeding on the tackle, so blood rule, he's got to come off the pitch and going to be wrapped up.
And a deep drive just over top of the bar. So Fabry getting a real quick tape job there, and luckily they'll have the goal kick as he looks to get back in here, and maybe a player warming up here to check in for the Capers as well.
Yeah, Campanella, nice shot on net there on that free kick.
And down to the pressure time here. 83-40 gone in this match.
Yeah, these last 10 minutes are pressure time for both teams. Cape Breton went through it the other day, and actually so did Acadia. UMB was in the ascendancy in that game, and so was St. FX against Cape Breton in their game. So, you know, they've already done it this week, and now they have to see if they can do it again as they go forward.
A couple of battle-tested squads here looking to come away with that banner. So the check-in coming here for the Capers. And it will be Ryan Gillis, or scratch that, that's Max Robb. And Voodoo out of the game.
It looks like they actually put the wrong number up on the board. It looks like it's actually Bent who's coming off for him.
And we saw Max Robb was a starter in that first game as well, so great depth on display here for these Capers.
Yeah, they're gonna. Looks like they're gonna look for a little bit more, size and a little bit more defense, and just keep putting the ball back down the pitch.
As it looked like Voodoo took that ball right to the face. Now moved forward here by the Axemen. Going to be grabbed there by Buck. And Buck able to move it forward. Maybe some space here for Acadia as a player taken down and no whistle.
No, he just he was trying to reach behind himself for the ball and just tried to get his body to it.
Another touch forward on the run here, Fenning. And Fenning was taken down.
Wow, I don't know what was, didn't seem to be much into that one. It looks like he just got his heel on it, but a free kick called just outside of the 18.
And a decent angle here, as good as a corner kick, but about 15 yards closer.
Yeah, but it's hard to get that ball back out from that end line. Referee's just backing the wall up. There's two people in the wall right now. Guessing. Comes in to help defend, so everybody back for Cape Breton.
So that kick popped up and nicely headed away now. Nagessen with it. And he tried to get it forward there for Voodoo. But it's going to be Acadia. Now back into their end as Snyder. Now retreating it back there to the goalkeeper Goodwin.
And Gessen's just run about 75 yards. Pritchard comes up with the ball.
And a beauty of a steal here, Pritchard, who assisted on that second goal. And he got it up there for Voodoo. Voodoo popping it up in the header, and he scores!
And that's in Gessen on the back post.
That might be the insurance marker at the 86-minute mark, and Cape Breton rallying around their man. An outstanding substitution.
And I just finished saying he'd run. He took the ball at the top of his own end 18, ran in and got in on the keeper, ran back out, and then ran back in for the header to score the goal.
As we see him sprinting to the sideline here as well, you know, still got some life left in those legs after sitting that first half.
Gotta love adrenaline. It keeps you running when you really shouldn't be, but he must have run about 140 yards.
And the man he took out, Stuart Heath, had the first two goals, and now Nagessen getting potentially the insurance marker here very late in this one.
And Acadia just looks to see if they can catch the Cape Breton goalie off his line. And a free kick coming up now to Acadia. To Cape Breton in the Acadia zone.
And they'll just take their time with it here.
Yeah, Shawley's just going to stand over top of this and probably just maybe drill it over top of the net or just drop it inside the box.
And he's going to pop one up. Daniels in the area. Now Paris moving it forward. And a nice run coming here from Fabry. And again, cleared out. And should the Capers be able to hold on here, you wouldn't consider this an upset because they've been in this position before. They go to Nationals almost annually out of this AUS, and a great effort so far.
Well, yeah, you know, Cape Breton, Acadia's showed some grit to come back and get that their one goal, but Cape Breton been very strong in maintaining that possession and getting the ball deep to their players.
So we'll get an Axemen throw in here. And again, just knocked out and a player down now into Capers territory. We'll get a look at who that is.
Rajic, and he got a yellow card as he got stuck in on a tackle. Both the players patting each other on the stomach, knowing full well that grit time, you've got to get in there.
And that was Fenning, the man that was down. Seems to be all right. So we'll get the free kick as we just passed the 89-minute marker.
And Rajic, the native of Quebec, showing a fair bit of grit on getting in on that tackle.
And a high ball. We'll see if they can get the head on it, but it is Chalet getting there and making up for that goal that he was beaten on earlier in the game. Now out of bounds and off an Axeman foot. Another player checking in here, and it's going to be Boudou subbing out of this game, as he's done great so far.
Subbing in number 44, Matt Larder, for number 19, Kalen Boudou.
So it's going to be Matt Larder into the game. And he gets a touch right away, looking up there for Daniels. Daniels over for Nagesson, and big contact on that last pass.
Larder getting in on the first one and actually nutmegs the first player he comes up against. Does a great job to get that ball in to Dimitri Daniels.
And now we're into added time here, the 90-minute mark. And they're going to put 4 minutes up, so still a bit of time left here for Acadia, but not much when you need two goals.
And Cape Breton here with a free kick deep in the zone. You know they're going to just play this short and try to maintain some possession for a few seconds. Larder's gone into the... Max Robb's gone into the corner, and you know he's going to get beaten around a fair bit down in there. They're just going to try to hold on to this ball as deep as they can.
And Acadia coming away with it now. They'll push everyone forward as a long lead feed, trying to find their man, Cooper Coates.
And again, Chalet, good tackle, slows it down, allows his defenders to get back with him.
Once again, looking there for Coates. And a ball up in the area, and Paris right there, running into the goalkeeper, who looks to have taken a fair bit of contact. And you hope that he's not too seriously hurt in the late goings of this one as he was up to contest that ball.
I think he looks like he may have been winded on that one. He went to the turf pretty hard on that ball.
Yeah, jumping up with the much larger Paris. They pushed forward, looking for the header. Paris has got to be 6'4", 6'5", out there.
And he's been a beast on the ball every time he gets up for it, whether it's in the midfield, the back line, or trying to go forward.
So we'll reset it from the Acadia end. About a minute and a half or 2 minutes gone here in extra time. And again, just firing it out into the parking lot. Now returning to play here. Acadia needs to put all balls towards the goal. Going to be grabbed there by Corey Cadeau. And once again, rolling out.
Yeah, Cadeau not given an opportunity to turn towards net as Daniels got in his back, and Cape Breton just happy to put that ball out of bounds and continue moving it along.
So the throw in there from Acadia. Really needing to make quick work here, but again, this defense has been stout all game long here for the Capers.
Yeah, Rajic there just getting himself thrown about and just putting the ball back down the field.
Maybe a look here towards the goal and a nice back pass shot and hitting the side of the net.
And it must have, I think Wilson got a hand on that one to push it wide.
So the corner kick coming here. Everyone in the area here for Acadia. And a Paris header. And somehow finding it there, Jamie Wilson through a crowd.
Now Jamie Wilson, native of Dunbar, Scotland, again being tough, coming out and grabbing that ball. And He's just going to get this down the pitch as far as he can. You can see Cape Breton's not too concerned about trying to move forward too fast.
Picked up now. Rodenizer trying to cross towards the goal and boot it up and into the Acadia bench.
Yeah, Shawley big in there again. Just clears that ball out and content just to put it up the pitch.
So a bouncing ball, Pritchard on the chase here. Getting physical with his man. That was Coates. Coates now here for the corner kick. And they're sending everyone up there. The goalkeeper, Goodwin, getting out to mid-pitch as well. And Coates popping it up. Trying to find Harris on the header.
Campanile just cleared that one up strong.
And now cleared up to mid-pitch once more. And we're looking like we're getting into the waning moments here as Goodwin now up on offense.
Nice touch by Goodwin to get it past the attacker.
And there's Cadeau. And Cadeau had it knocked off his boots. And once again sent all the way down. And now a player down behind the play there.
That was Shawley. Got pulled. He got slide tackle from behind by Acadia's goaltender, Nigel Goodwin.
Pulling the card out there and assessing it to Goodwin as well. So hopefully Shawley's all right, but precious time winding down in a two-goal deficit.
We've got to be down into just mere seconds left here, and Jamie Wilson from Cape Breton comes over to see Shawley to see if he's all right.
And a great sight along that Cape Breton sideline as well. All the players linked arm-in-arm here.
You see Heath sitting there having a conversation with Goodwin.
And there it is. For the fourth time in the school's history, the Cape Breton Capers are AUS champions with that 3-1 victory over Acadia. And what a great sight and all the excitement there. You got to love seeing that. And Dom, what can you say about this program and about the season that they've had?
Well, you know, it all came down to this. They put it into a bunch of power, speed, great preparation. Coach Dino Morley had them ready for this, saw what they were going to look at, knew that they had to push forward as hard and as strong as they could, keep ball under control, keep possession, keep moving it forward, get everybody involved. Big fullbacks in the back like Shawley, who's been an absolute workhorse, as well as Pritchard. That nice ball over to Heath at the back to maybe to give them the second goal. Phenomenal play all around, and what a great game and strong play by their all the way from their keeper Wilson all the way up to Heath.
As we see them tackling the keeper there, and you know, just talk about the response as well. This game had been tied up at 1-1, Acadia getting that goal and looking like they found a spark, but they were able to keep their composure on the Capers' side.
Well, you know, that's what it was all about. They kept focused. They knew they had a job to do. They didn't panic. They were delighted with what they were able to potentially push forward. They worked together as a team from the get-go. You know, you got to give credit to Acadia. They got that ball forward. They got the MVP all the way up into the top. Andrew Schneider nodding the ball over top of Jamie Wilson. But Cape Breton didn't stop, knew they still had a job to do, knew they could do it. And you can see the celebration by Ngess in there, the third goal, and great work all the way across.
Yeah, the first two goals being scored there by Stuart Heath and Nagesson on the second. And Stuart Heath, a potential man of the match candidate here. He wasn't a starter in that first game. They inserted him into the starting lineup here, and the fresh blood really working out.
You know, Heath, with beard and all, he was just phenomenal up there, and what a great target. And you can see Heath celebrating with his teammates on the side after that second goal. Pritchard picking him out at the back post. Look, you can see this. Pritchard just looks downfield, knows that Heath's going to come across, and bang, back post goal. Phenomenal play by Heath, getting open all the time. Big, strong man up front, and can't say too much about him. He played fantastic.
And just a great sight right there. All the players jumping up and down. And we're going to send you to a quick commercial break and be right back for the trophy presentation to the Cape Breton Capers here on TV1.
AUS football season, and Bella Line 5TV1 has you covered. Strong rivalries run deep as the X-Men, the Mounties, the X-Men, and the Huskies battle it out all season long. And with 5TV1, you won't miss a game. For hard-hitting, adrenaline-pumping AUS football, there's only one. Bella Line 5TV1, live on Channel 1 at 4:01. Football so intense, you won't know what hit you. Watch AUS football presented by Subway, the official fuel of Atlantic University Sport.
These are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs. And these, wait for it, are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs with no artificial colors, flavors, or preservatives. It's a big change you can feel good about. And it's how we're leading our commitment to feel good, taste good food. Make all your sand wishes come true at Subway.
The CFL in our...
And we are down here on the pitch here at the BMO Center. Quickly, Dino Morley, 2 years as a bridesmaid. Now you're a champion.
It's hard to keep the emotions in check, actually. We've been ready for this. We've worked hard for this. And finally, it's our day.
Stuart Heath came out playing all day, got two key goals, including the game winner.
He's our captain. He started the season with a fractured bone. He's struggled to get back. He's battled. He's worked hard. He's shown heart. And he got his reward today. It's beautiful.
Dino, look behind you. Look at your team. They're celebrating. They're champions. Go ahead, celebrate with them.
Thanks very much. Thank you.
All right, back upstairs, guys.
Thank you so much, Roger. And, you know, Dom, you've been around the game quite a while. You know, if you're a coach, how are you feeling right now? What are the endorphins like?
It's hard to explain how well you feel out there. I mean, you know, you're just so pumped. You've been able to push your team out. You've got them prepared, and it's never feels better than that. And as they said, you know, 2 years bridesmaid, 1 year, now they're up there, and they're the ones out there.
And we're going to send you to the in-game PA announcer for the presentation of the banner.
Cape Breton Capers, and he is number 23, Corey Banks. We would now ask that the captains of the Cape Breton University Capers to please come forward for the presentation of the AUS Men's Soccer Championship banner and trophy.
Job.
The Acadia Axemen and the Cape Breton University Capers will both advance to represent the AUS Conference at the 2016 Youth Sports Men's Soccer Championship, being hosted next weekend by the University of Guelph.
He'll be there shortly.
So we are just moments away from the post-game interview with MVP Corey Bent. We heard the chanting going on. You know, what do you think about his play this tournament?
What can you say about Corey Bent? That man is just motion and speed, strength. Seeing the way he danced around some of the players was just unbelievable. The native Preston, UK, brilliant play and well deserved.
And now we're going to send it down to Roger Surrette with Corey Bent.
Corey Bent, MVP here for the Cape Breton Capers, champion. How's that sound?
It's not sunk in yet, you know, like me and 13 of the lads, new faces, all come together, really gelled really quickly. It's been amazing. It's been a massive journey for me. And look at them, they're all shouting my name, and it's the best feeling ever. So,
listen to them. They're yelling out MVP. add that to your name, MVP of the AUS playoffs. How does that it's gonna sink in eventually, but having this entire team be having your back,
they all support me, you know, everyone, even myself, everyone does the work behind the scenes to allow me to be the player that I am. You know, everyone allows me to be free, express myself on the pitch, and that's why I can't take all of the credit. That everyone else behind me is the ones putting the work in as well.
Corey, you were staring at that MVP plaque. Now it's time to go stare at that championship trophy and that banner. Go ahead and celebrate.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right. Upstairs, guys.
Thanks a lot, Roger. And, you know, Dom, you see the look of sheer joy on all of their faces. But, you know, still a job to do next weekend for both of these teams heading to Nationals. How do you feel that they stack up against the rest of the country?
Well, you know, there's some powerhouses out there in youth sports soccer across the nation. But you've got to admire a young team like Cape Breton. They're going to be around for a while. You take a look at all the number ones along with the players, including the MVP, Corey Bent. He's a rookie. I think these guys are going to impress a lot of people, and I think they're going to surprise people out there with their ability from Shelley in the back to Bent up front. What a package.
Now, we talked about the MVP. Who is the unsung hero for this Capers team? Is there a guy that you can look at who maybe didn't get all the flashy goals or anything like that, but put in a good effort?
You know who I'm going to call on? I'm a center back myself, and you got to like the big Shelley in the back. Those balls he was clearing out, he got caught on one, but one in two games that, you know, he just kept coming through, clearing the ball out. Fantastic work by him to be able to continually get to the ball and push it out. He's my unsung hero.
As we see on the screen there, Dimitri Daniels with the trophy. He was another player that came off the bench for this Capers team, taking a moment to celebrate. But what can you say about his game?
You know, Dimitri Daniels' strength in the midfield, getting in on the ball, pushing the ball around. And at the end, he was pushing those balls wide and allowing his players to get up the pitch. Great work by him. And you also have to love Campanile as well. I mean, Campanile pushed in a lot on the balls and strength. So, you know, from front to back again, they played as a team, and it takes 11 players to be able to win a trophy like this, especially over a tournament in this colder weather.
We've been here for 3 days now this weekend, and, you know, BMO Center as a host, UNB as a host. We weren't expecting maybe much by way of fans here in this championship game, but they showed out in droves and very vocal. What can you say about this host?
You know what? It's fantastic that UNB and the city of Fredericton able to host this AUS championship. A few hundred fans out on a cold, very cold fall day here, and we're just lucky. The pitch looked in good condition. Everybody was up for it, and there were players, fans out in the rain, fans out in the wind, and fans out to see this final game, even when the host team wasn't involved.
And, you know, the weather as well is another thing that these players battled through, but the wind stayed down today, and as well as the rains stayed away. So about as perfect conditions as you could want here on a November day.
Absolutely. You know, we got to see the players play and just let them do what they do best. And then we actually did see the best. You had some brilliant play. Heath, Campanile, Bent, Shelley, fantastic all the way around. You got to give credit to Acadia. Strong game, didn't put their head down, but they just, at the end of the day, they didn't have it left in the tank to be able to compete with the speed of Cape Breton.
Yeah, and for Acadia as well, like we had mentioned, they are going to Nationals next week. They will play now one of the higher-seeded teams, and what adjustments do they need to make to try and compete?
Well, you know, they've got to forget about this weekend. They've got to get back and start focusing on where they're going to be next weekend, start thinking about the next targets, and come together as a team, help each other out.
It's going to be just a great championship hosted by Guelph as well in the now-called U Sports Championship Final. What do you think about that rebranding? We got U Sports now instead of the CIS.
Well, you know, it's fantastic, actually. I like the fact that it's a bilingual logo. It's a bilingual name. You don't have to worry about switching back and forth between French and English. So U Sport, it works on both sides. And flashy, bright, I like it. Actually, it's clean.
As we still await Roger Surrett with another sideline interview, just maybe thoughts overall on the weekend. We had six teams come in here and play, and they all put their best foot forward.
Yeah, you know, I think it was great soccer all around. Beyond the first two games that we watched on when was that? I guess that was all the way back on Thursday when we had 8 goals scored between the two games. Everything else was really tight. 1-goal games all the way through except for this, which was 2. And, you know, it was fantastic strength. Oh, you can see they're going after Coach Dino Morley on the pitch now and throwing him up in the air. Big smile on Coach Morley's face, and they're tossing him up in the air. Hands are up there. That's what you call about celebrating with your team.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant display here by these Cape Breton Capers. We're going to send you to a quick commercial break and be right back with Roger Surrett with some more sideline interviews here on TV One.
It's AUS football season, and Bellaline 5TV1 has you covered. Strong rivalries run deep as the X-Men, the Mounties, the X-Men, and the Huskies battle it out all season long. And with 5TV1, you won't miss a game. For hard-hitting, adrenaline-pumping AUS football, there's only one. Bellaline 5TV1, live on Channel 1 at 4:01. Football so intense, you won't know what hit you. Watch AUS football presented by Subway, the official fuel of Atlantic University Sport.
These are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs. And these, wait for it, are Subway's roast beef and turkey breast subs with no artificial colors, flavors, or preservatives. It's a big change you can feel good about. And it's how we're leading our commitment to feel good, taste good food. Make all your sandwiches come true at Subway.
The CFL and our partners at Football Canada want to make sure we keep growing, promoting, and investing in a safe game.
Hit!
Football Canada now requires all amateur coaches to be safe contact trained by 2017. By creating a standard of safety for all in our football community, we're making an already great game even better. Make sure your youth coach is safe contact trained, because making a safe game means making a better game.
And there it is, ladies and gentlemen, 3-1, the final score, and the Cape Breton Capers are your AUS champions. Don Blakely, thank you so much for spending this weekend here with me.
Thanks a lot, Mike. I had a great time being up here and working in the booth with you. It's been a really fun time and some great soccer that we got to watch.
And everyone at home as well, thank you so much, and we will see you next time on TV One.